Hello, and welcome back to Alan Wake 1, where we're going to do the DLC, and then hopefully we'll do American Nightmare, and we can move on to Control, if my computer runs it. So let's start.
Something I only know is the dark presence held my wife captive and used to write a horror story that came true.
I'll bring her back.
Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Yep, that happened.
Ellen?
I saved Alice and wrote a better ending for the story, but not without a price. I was trapped somewhere in the dark place, a strange zone somewhere beyond our world.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
Okay.
After the completion of any difficult undertaking, there are mixed emotions. Accomplishment and relief. Sadness, depression. For a while, everything was about the work. Like an illness, it consumed you, changed you. You locked yourself away from the world to do it, and now you need to recover, learn to live without it, find a way to crack open the door, and let the light back in.
Is it Scratch?
I knew this place. It was familiar.
Oh no, it's just actually Alan.
But wrong somehow.
Oh, okay.
Everything had a surreal, dreamlike quality.
I can't. Oh, so I get manuscripts. Oh no, this is the. Okay.
I had a disturbing feeling of deja vu. I had no idea why I was here or where I had been before this moment. But something was waiting for me at the back of the diner.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Except here is no longer human.
Oh.
Nothing but black coffee under a layer of skin.
Okay.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
It's a song.
Again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable. It does that. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good solid whack. Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
Oh, it even.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Yeah, it's a distorted version of it. That's interesting. Okay. There's a clock there. Oh god, the clock is so loud. Alright, what horror movie is gonna wait me here? Okay. Sure. Oh god.
Alan, listen to me. Go no deeper.
What?
Focus. You're losing yourself. I will try to help the best I can, but it's up to you. Find a better point of contact.
What do you mean?
I cannot hear you. Please, you're the one making all this happen. Concentrate. This is what's happening.
Nightmares. Too deep. Can't take the pressure. It's too much.
Suddenly, Wake found himself face to face with himself.
Okay, that's Scratch for sure, right?
The dream suddenly became lucid. The dark place. That's where I was.
You will need weapons.
Oh god.
It's not the light itself, but what it represents. You will need it.
Okay, here we go again.
This is not a gun. It is a tool and a light. biological process of elimination. Be careful. I will try to find a better point of contact.
I didn't understand Zane's message, and knowing where I was didn't fix anything. Something had gone wrong after I had finished departure.
Fuck you. Oh, God.
What the hell was that?
Jay had come back. The diner had become deserted. Then the door was smashed off its hinges and Wake had to fight for his life.
All right, there we go. Oh, fuck me. God, I forgot how much I hate this game. The gameplay, it kills me.
Zane, wait for me.
The world had become twisted. These trees didn't belong there.
Oh, fuck. Fuck off. Fuck. Fuck off. Ow, ow, ow. Holy shit, what the fuck? Okay.
Hey, wait for me.
Okay. I'm just gonna run. Can I run? God damn it, Alan. You really need to work on your fucking thing. Fuck. Oh.
I knew it was my writing, but the words were jumbled to dreamlike fragments, reloading frantically. The rounds of the slippery stone was thrown away from the tent. The bed looked inviting, but it was just the radio. I had to go on. She was startled by the phone.
Verizon.
Sense for the GPS system to work. I doubted any satellite was in range here. These were alien skies, but it was guiding me towards something. Towards Zane?
I'm trying. Anything else, Zane? Nope. That's it? Okay. Something had shifted. Oh my god. The dark place was playing tricks on me. That's pretty cool. Stay still.
The town itself turned against Wake. Cars flew toward him. He cracked bone and crushed muscle. It oozed hate. I wanted to bury him.
Right. Great. Oh my god. Really? All of these cars. Fuck me. Okay. Took that straight to the face. Fuck. Door hurts. Door hurts. Okay. I read as tits. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Jesus Christ. Oh. Mm-hmm. God, I forgot how much I hated this part of the game.
Everything I saw was familiar, and yet it wasn't.
Hello.
I cannot keep up. You're going too deep. I will try to guide you. Follow the signal.
I'm trying.
You must face yourself. Follow me.
Oh!
Oh,
the GPS system was supposed to lead me to Zane, but the shifts were interfering with it. I had to keep trying. I wouldn't survive alone.
Okay. Yeah, it got a bit confused up there. Oh my god.
The changes were becoming more violent. The street wasn't so much ripped apart as it was missing. Like some great hand had reached down and scooped it up.
Just drops it out of the bloody sky. Fuck! All right, jeez. Don't touch the words. I was trying to catch it before it fell. Oh, that scared me. Sarah Breaker, Bright's false fighters, the red hot cop chick with the lightning fast boomstick, her debut book, The Only Girl in the Bookhouse, delves deep into the double life of having a successful law enforcement career while being involved in a secret society. How does Daddy's Little Trooper fit into an old-fashioned fraternity? Can I get her as a like a an additional help? Oh, when not in combat, you run just fine, huh? Oh fuck. Okay, here we go. Fuck off. Without shit. Fuck off. Fuck off, fuck off, fuck off. What the fuck? I probably have to spam the shits. Oh, this is much more difficult. Oh, fuck off with that shit. Fuck. Fuck. God, I hate this fucking combat. So bad. I've used literally everything I had. Oh, thank you. Thank you, bud. Oh. Oh, that's great. Call me Beep Me.
Where are you? Look, I'm trying to follow your goddamn signal.
The dark place is playing tricks on you. You're still going deep. I'm trying to guide you, but it's hard.
What is this?
I can help you if you just stop sinking.
What? This is bullshit.
It's happening again. Brace yourself.
Maybe follow. Checkpoint reached. Fuck off with that. Fuck off. Okay, they kill themselves. Fuck. My god, this is way harder than the actual normal game. Memory. Okay, not bad. Probably want to start using flare gun. This year I'm running out of flares. Okay, thanks for narrating, Oh, I hear a clock. Okay. All right. Fuck off. Aha. At least this is easier to fucking deal with than literally anything else. Like, you're clearly going deeper. Oh god. Yeah. Okay. Fuck me. Okay. Ow. Holy shit, okay. Ma'am? I'm gonna give Pastor Howard a piece of my mind about this lock. Okay. I told him to get it fixed. Ah, I hate this game. I love the story, but I hate the comments so much. Right. Is that Barry? Hey, Barry. Barry Wheeler, the literary agent of the constant ailment, the frantic sidekick with the ectic rhetoric, the owner of the most fashionable jacket ever made, and the author of the indispensable guide to would-be agents everywhere, Blood from a Rock, When the Goose Starts Gold-Bricking, presents a new collection of short fiction by Alan Wake. Included are classics like Herod Boy, as well as numerous mortifyingly clumsy early works buried deep in the disappeared writer's files. Never intended for publication, that's not the Wheeler way. Get yours now. So this is a fucking alternative reality where they're all authors somehow. Right.
The world was... It was changing. Twisting out of control. It was too big on the inside. He couldn't see the ceiling. Something was moving in there. He was lost. He couldn't find the exit.
Asshole.
This is what I think about your exit. Oh great. I have
were getting more severe. I wasn't sure if the place got bigger or I got smaller.
Oh boy.
The signal was going haywire. I would have to find my way out of here on my own.
I have to be careful not to point my thing at any of these. Okay. Fuck. Absolutely hate this game. Like, the goddamn gameplay is absolute dog shit. Fuck off. Okay. I hear sounds and I'm scared. Fuck off. So tense. Pretty sure I put it on easy too, which is fucking bullshit. Me a page. He was trying to help me. I mean, yeah, easy has been. Friend?
Yowza! Barry? Hey, bestseller! Looking good!
You're not real.
Well, no shit. What gave me away? What, the see-through thing? I'm a figment of your imagination, just like pretty much everything else you see here. Maybe even you.
That's insane.
Yeah, you're right. Everything that happened before made perfect sense, but this is insane. Good catch, Al.
Okay, look, I gotta get going. The GPS...
The GPS, yeah, I know. Follow the signal. Got it.
Okay. Bestseller?
So, hey, I'm here to help you. The thing is, you need to get a grip, all right?
You nag the way the real Barry does, you know that?
Well, hey, you know, be fair. It's not my fault you think I'm annoying.
I don't think you're annoying.
Al, baby, relax, it's cool. Just try to stay on the ball here. You need to do what Zane tells you. He's been here for ages. He's like the expert.
Okay. And that includes...
Anyway, if this is insane, and it's all from your mind, what's that say about you?
Fine. Enough. I can't believe I was actually happy to see you.
Oh, come on. Don't shit a shitter, Al. Deep down, you're always happy to see me. Can't lie to yourself, know what I'm saying?
I must be a sucker for punishment.
You? No, really? And I always thought you went out of your way to avoid trouble.
Thanks for that.
Yes! The safety. Safety flashlight. Oh. They really improved the shadow look.
I think the signal's pointing towards that thing in the distance.
Yeah. That'd be the Biltmore sawmill.
How the hell do you know that?
I don't know anything you don't. So why don't you ask yourself that? Huh? Maybe you saw a sign for it back in the real world. Or maybe it's the sawmill, because I said it's the sawmill, and now you can't get it out of your head.
Oh, he really is see-through.
Yeah, sure has given me a headache. Or is that your headache? Do you have a headache?
Barry.
Dude, we're bonding.
We're bonding, dude. I miss Barry.
Ooh, mama! Hey, Al! I guess the pen is mightier
than... If you complete that sentence, you're fired.
Mightier than the sword?
You're fired.
Aww.
He's not real. I guess that's... for me to use. Oh, thank God. Okay. Yeah. Fuck. Scared the shit out of me. I don't like the sound of that. Possessed. Oh shit. Fuck. Oh. Nice. Oh, aha. That code doesn't say how many.
You know, you're gonna have to make your way across here.
Yeah?
I'm thinking the solution probably has something to do with those words.
Really? You think?
Yeah, you should probably use them.
Your insight is staggering.
I know.
I thought he was just gonna drop him. Whoa.
See, this is the way things should be. I give advice and you follow. That's when things go right. When you get up to something on your own, that's when the trouble starts.
That's horseshit.
Al, I'm not saying anything you haven't come up with first. Figment, remember?
This kind of thing could drive a man insane.
No! This is great! And it's probably therapeutic for you too.
Uh-huh. Let's see, think you over. Since you're Weaver, the Lady of the Light, the cloud of gloom in the well-lit room, Weaver's difficult and uncompromising life is illuminated in Cynthia Weaver carrying the torch. An enlightening and occasionally harrowing biography by Ellen Adams, who was an intern at Bright Falls Record under Weaver's editorship. Oh god. It's fucking TV again. Yeah.
Transmissions of myself before, but not like this. The version of myself I saw now sounded insane, like a demented storyteller who was out to destroy its protagonist.
Oh, I can't pick up the other one. Great, thanks. Okay. Alan. Okay, there we go. was gonna say, you're stupid. Yeah, they really improved the shadows effects for the DLC. Oh god, hello. The fuck did you drop from? Okay. Mm-hmm. Possessed enemy ravens. Fuck. I caught my books are my fucking death.
Ow, come on. You gotta be careful. Those are bad words.
I can see that. Fuck off. Okay, so they give you the bad words in the middle of fucking bird spotting. Just to fuck with you. Cool. Thanks. Just go around. How about that bitch? How them apples taste, huh? Fuck you and your bad words. Oh, okay. Well, that's not good.
Okay, this is just too weird. You're weird.
Fuck you.
Is all this really coming out of my head? That's just the way this place is, Al. All that random stuff in your head? Imagination.
But you're from my imagination.
Yeah, you know what, Al? Do yourself a favor. Don't pursue that train of thought any further.
Thanks, Barry. You're always there for me. Fuck. Fuck off. Are they just gonna spawn around me? Should I just be going? Yeah, they're just gonna keep spawning. Okay, I'm just gonna run for it then. As long as I stay in the light, it should be fine. Ow, 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 ow. Right. Fuck me. This is terrible. I hate this. Fuck me. Okay. Oh. Fuck off. Oh, can I heal? Thank you. Oh god. The soul DLC has got me on edge. Jesus Christ. Ugh. Thor Henderson, the God of Thunder, the boozing geezer with the anger and the hammer. Come one, come all, face the age of murder and storm. Discovered by Barry Wheeler, this fresh new voice from a bygone era suggests new and innovative solutions to old problems. Don't you dare leave your bookstore without the best-selling self-help book, You're All Nails to Me. Foreword by Barry Wheeler. You got some weird imagination, dude.
Into the warehouse. That's the way forward.
If I'm making this up, why is it so complicated?
Because you're a complicated man, and no one understands you. But I'm talking.
Barry.
Right. Fuck. Me? Okay. They can reach me here, right? Fuck. That scared the big shit out of me. Okay. All right. Fuck off. Fuck off. They quite literally blew up my car. Okay. Fuck. Fuck off. Oh, fuck off with that shit. Fuck. Fuck off. Oh god, the camera, I forgot. Oh, fuck off. Fuck off. God damn. God, I hate this game. The story is so good, but the goddamn combat is an absolute travesty. Oh boy. Yeah, that was awful. That was the worst thing. The base game was actually fine. Like, somehow the DLC, they've made it worse. Oh god. Aunt? Oh, Aunting Raffle. It's a very confused hunt. I don't trust you.
Hey, what are you up to? I thought this was my side of the bed.
Okay. It's a sweet memory, I guess. Oh, fuck's sake.
He entered the trap, surrounded by enemies. We get nowhere to run.
Damn it! I'm so sick of you!
Fuck off. I'm so sick of you is the appropriate response to this. Okay. God damn. Oh, there's an even more heavy-duty flashlight. Holy shit. Okay. Oh, this is not a good place.
Oh, that's never a good sound, is it?
No.
No,
it isn't.
No, it isn't. What if I run away, huh? What are you gonna do now? Okay. This is probably like the next checkpoint is the end of me playing this for today because this is a bit too stressful for my fucking heart. I'm already at the risk of hypertension, alright? I don't need this shit in my life. Fuck. This is not good for my heart. This is not good for my heart. My heart is already so bad. Like, I don't need this in my life. Oh, hi. I don't know how many of these I've collected. All right, let's just save me, please. Oh, okay. Oh, fuck. This is not good for my heart. Like, this is somehow, like, more tighter, even on easy, like, than, like, fucking the normal game. And it's just so terrifying. Oh, God. But yeah, Where the fuck is this going? I don't know, but I guess we'll see. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.